I don't know. Akio didn't seem like he had so many issues. Well, actually he did. Because they destroyed his sacred place. So maybe, I don't know how to resolve that. That's why we're gonna do this. So what's up guys, 3-Point Saber here. We're back with more Clannad. We're gonna do Akio's story. It's gonna be interesting because I honestly don't know what to expect. Akio! I don't know how to... Usually Akio is the one... What? Oh. Usually Akio is the one to save everyone. Well, at least the main character. I don't know how the main character can exceed and go above beyond Akio and save him instead. Oh, this is new! Oh, it's not new. But now I know who the fuck this is! This is his daughter! I thought it was Nagisa this entire time. That's actually his daughter. Dang. I didn't realize how long the route was. Seeing Nagisa, I'm like, damn. Because his daughter was like, uh-oh. Okay. I should at least... Okay. Oh man. I should just make the same choices. Yeah, that's a good idea. Just make the same choices. The only thing I need to do is... say, okay, fine. Oh, go back. That way I can just skip it. Easy. Founders Festival. I'll go through it. Naked Apron Day.
Tomoya-kun, yep. Shigoto no koto de.
Naked Apron Day? I chose that. Ah! I'm supposed to say, okay, fine. But I don't know when. They just told me say, okay, fine. And then you and Akio row. Not too much, it's impossible. Wait, go back! What's the other choice? Man, I should've paid attention. Oh! God damn it, it's this one! See, I almost fucked up the Akio row. And I'm like, wait a minute! It's not okay, it's oh fine. Okay. Okay, now we successfully in Akio row. I don't need this anymore. So the situation is, Nagisa asked if I could take over and help bake bread for the family, but in place of her dad, because her dad's going to go chase a dream. So I just told Nagisa, alright, I'll make the bread. Spend 50 million lost, just like the other us. Nah, I got this. Yeah, I understand how you feel too.
ありがとうございます.
Wait a minute. Is this one for safe? I hope it's. The large body man is leaning against the horizontal bar in the park and smoking a cigarette. Okay, I was making sure I got the right one. Hey, isn't that your old man? Skipping again? We decided to head through the park. Old man!
Oh, nanda temera ka?
Okay, I gotta make sure.
Oto-san, tadaima desu.
Okaeri.
Oto-san, kore mite kudasai. Watashi ga tsukutte kimashita. Nishime desu.
Nishime desu. Oh.
ああ、一気食いしてやるさ。
そんな食べ方したらダメです。味わって食べてほしいです。
任せておけ。
それとですね、とてもいいお話があります。
お、なんだ？お前が家に戻ってくるのか？そりゃ朗報だ。
戻らないです。智也君と一緒にいたいです。
ち、分かってるよ。わざわざ口に出して一緒にいたいなんて言うな。こいつがニヤニヤしてるだろ。
How do you know? Naisa looks at me.
別にニヤニヤしてないです。
今さっと真顔に戻りやがった。こいつむっつりスケベだ。
むっつりって何ですか？わからないです。
むちゃくちゃスケベなのに普段はおしかくしてるやつのことだよ。
ともやくん、そんなんじゃないです。我慢させてしまったりして、私の方が申し訳なく思っています。
Are you really going to say that in front of your parents? As always, it seems like it's going to take a while before we can actually talk about the matter at hand. Just as I look over at the front of Full Cup Bread, Sanae-san comes out to watch us.She smiles at me and walks closer. Sup?
Konnichiwa, Tomoya-san.
Oh, Okaa-san desu. Tadaima desu.
Okaeri nasai. Akio-san.
At the green eyes of a smile, she shoots a cute glare at the old man.
Yo, Sanae.
Akio-san, dame desu yo. Itsu datte Akio-san wa sugu inaku natte shimau n desu kara.
I knew he was playing hooky.
Kyaku mo konakute taikutsu datta nda. Wari ne.
Is that supposed to be a valid excuse?
Taikutsu datta n desu ka? Nara, shikata ga nai desu ne.
It worked! It actually is a valid excuse!
Kondo kara taikutsu shinai you ni asobu mono motte misebaan shite ru yo.
Onegai shimasu ne.
And I have to spend my day off baking bread in place of this man-child!
というわけで、智也くんがお父さんの代わりに、土曜と日曜はパンを焼いてくれます。
おー、ラッキー。じゃあ、俺は昼までゆっくり寝てるな。
違います。演劇、見に行ってきてください。
演劇？
そうです。友達が旗揚げ公演するから来てくださいって招待状届いてました。
ちっ、んなこと誰から聞いたんだよ。
私です。
Sanae-san really is an honest person. You should go. I'll bake all the bread for you.
てめえな、簡単に素人に任せられるような仕事じゃねえんだよ。
I thought you were just going on about how you lucked out.
うせえ。さっきのは冗談だ。
I knew it. He wants to do everything he can to keep from talking about plays in front of Nagisa.
お父さん、お願いです。行ってきてください。
アキオさん、意地を張らないで行ってきてください。
That's right. Go!
てめえは黙れ。
Wow! Why me and not them?
お父さん、自然に振る舞ってほしいです。このことだけは気を使ってます。私に対して。
私、お茶入れてきますね。
Sanae-san stands up from her chair. Oh, let me use your bathroom. I got to leave the scene along with her. When I get back, Sanae-san is in the middle of setting some tea up on the register.
Tomoya-san もどうぞ。
Sure. Thank you. The old man is smoking a cigarette with a grim face.
お父さん、早く行ってください。
After blowing out his smoke for a remarkably long time,
行ってまいります。
He announces to her.
そうですか。お店の方は私たちに任せておいてください。
よかったです。
I don't know how they persuaded him, but I guess even the old man couldn't keep refusing his beloved daughter remonstrations. 1 week passes, and we approach Thursday morning, the time the old man is supposed to depart. Okay. Leaving things to her sure took a lot of thought. He stares at our faces for a while, then closes his eyes as through stilling his resolve and departs. After that, the three of us continue on tirelessly baking bread. Once the store opens, Nagisa manages to register all by herself. As Anaisa and I continue working in the kitchen together. Gotcha. I cram the iron plate with a final batch into the oven. I'll just switch over with Nagisa later then. So Nagisa leaves, taking with her the tray of freshly baked bread. God, I'm tired. It's pretty unsightly, considering I actually do manual labor on a regular basis. Maybe it's because I'm even more fussy about things than normal, since it was my first time. Sick of good long resting. I leave the kitchen as well, and move over to the living room. I take off my apron and lie down. Tomoya-kun. I wake to someone calling me. Yeah. What is it? Is it already that time? Did you eat breakfast?
時間なかったです。
Will you be okay?
はい、お昼まで我慢します。
Make sure to eat your lunch properly, nice and slowly, alright?
はい、そうさせてもらいます。それでは行ってきます。
She hurriedly leaves. I better hurry back too.
また来てくださいね。
So Nai-san walks all the way to the entrance, seeing the customer off. The store is devoid of customers now. It seems like we're just about to hit our drop-off in customer traffic.
Tomoya-san.
I'll be taking over for Nagisa.
はい、お願いしますね。
Though, having just one person tend the store might be enough at this hour.
そうですね。 Tomoya-san, 休んでいてもらっても結構ですよ。
No, not me. I mean, you should be the one taking the breaks, Nai-san. You've been working non-stop ever since this morning, right?
私は全然平気ですよ。お客さんとお話できますし、楽しいです。
I see. It looks like she's insistent on manning the store. Well, please let me join you then.
入りたいですか?
Quite.
じゃ、入れちゃいますね。
Thank you very much. When she says this, we both laugh together. Still though, I'm pretty jealous of the old man. Being able to work with you like this.
そうですか?
Yeah, since you can laugh together like this every day.
Tomoya-san の職場は笑い合えないんですか?
Well, I laugh on occasions whenever we're taking a break. But I get smacked in the head if I actually let out a grin while on the job.
それは大変ですね。
Well, it's a man's job, after all. I guess it's normal.
Akio-san は毎日大笑いしてますよ。
Yeah, I bet. It's probably all thanks to you that he can laugh like that, though.
言うのに、何ですか?
Because he's always skipping out on work.
そうですね。いつもどこかに行っちゃいますね。
I really wonder how that guy can do something like that. Pushing all the work on you.
それほど私は気にしてませんよ。
Even so, at least Nagisa and I are together.
はい、ではそばにいてくださいね。
Yeah, leave it to me. Wait a minute. Isn't this kinda... It's almost like I'm confessing to her here! Not just that. So please stay right here with me, okay? Does that mean you're actually okay with it, Sanae-san? What the hell am I thinking? But having her look at me like that at point blank range, Sanae-san. Grumble.
そうですね。お腹すきましたね。それではお昼ご飯の用意をしてきますので、お店の方お任せしてよろしいですか?
Yeah. After seeing Sanae-san off, I take a deep breath. Yeah, it's true. I love Sanae-san. But only as family. It's a different love from what I feel for Nagisa. Yeah, that's right. Of course it is. It's obvious, really. Pain.
Dozo, meshiagatte kudasai ne.
Whoa.
Hai. Douka shimashita ka?
Nah, it's just this is unexpected. Neatly lined up on the dining table with spaghetti Napolitan, accompanied by lettuce-covered potato salads and slices of baked what? So you made this just now, Sanae-san?
Hai, tsukurimashita yo.
So as long as bread isn't involved, she can actually prepare normal, or rather quite exceptional dishes. I definitely can't say that out loud that I'm actually marveling about that fact though. You're quite thorough, huh? It looks really delicious. So I'll leave it at that.
Arigatou gozaimasu.
Even though we're still working, we eat Sanae-san homemade food together. Even long after lunch is over, it's still just the two of us. Not to mention there are so few customers, we spend the entire time just babbling with each other. Taking the job may have been a good idea after all. A child that looks to be in elementary school peeks into the store through the entrance.
どうしましたか?
Sanae-san asks him with a smile.
Akio-san いないの?
Hi.
アキオさんは出かけていて、明日の夜まで帰ってこないんですよ。ええ、こんな大事な時に。野球ですか?うん。僕、リトルリーグの補欠なんだけどさ。アキオさんがレギュラーになるまで一緒に練習してくれるって。そうですか。Sanae-san
looks my way. ええ、 Don't tell me.
お店の方は私一人で大丈夫なので。 練習に付き合ってあげてくれませんか?
No, I'm really bad at baseball!
大丈夫です!
What do you mean it'll be fine? Sanae-san gently brings her mouth over to my ear.
一人だと不安なんですよ. それだけですから.
Are you serious?
はい!
She immediately turns back toward the child with a smile.
今日と明日はこのお兄さんが代わりに見てくれます.
I'm the one who wants to complain here.
このお兄さんはともやさんと言って、アキオさんととても似ていて頼りになりますよ。まあ、いっか。Well,
whatever, my ass.
それでは、ともやさん、よろしくお願いしますね。
I can't just bluntly refuse someone that they're spurring me with such a perfect smile.
早く行こうよ、兄ちゃん。
Ah, seriously, why do I have to babysit this impotent brat? There goes my wonderful time alone time with Sanae-san.
ほら!
Yeah, fine. With a painful reluctance, I leave the store behind. Push-ups, sit-ups, Hindu squats, 3 sets of 20 each! These are fundamentals of muscle training that are important no matter what you do. So quit complaining, just do them! Sit down and start doing sit-ups. I watch over him as he does his workout and think to myself, Sanae-san and Nagisa keep telling me about this too, but am I really that much like the old man? When even this child I never even met tells me that, I start wondering whether there might be some truth to it. I'm like him? This guy that probably be in the top ranking for a good-for-nothing adult? It's quite a shock. I hang my head. And when I do... I hear several children's voices. When I raise my head, I see a bunch of children wearing baseball uniforms looking at me from outside the park. They all run up to me while shouting. And when they're right in front of me, they suddenly slam on the brakes. They're all ganging up on me now. Shut up! I can do whatever I want! I just get pissed in return. And don't put me in the same league as that guy! How would I be a fake? I'm obviously just a different person! Scram! I kicked the ground, sending sand everywhere. They all scramble away like baby spiders. Actually, he's gone for just one day. Things are already like this. Just how many brats is that guy playing with? I'm back.
Okaerinasai. もう渚も戻ってきていますよ.
I thought I smelled something different. So she's making dinner right now.
え、渚一人に任せておくのも悪いですので、手伝いに行きますね.
What should I do then?
もう店は閉めますので、もしよろしければパンのお裾分けに回ってもらえますか?
You mean that thing the old man always does?
はい.
I don't mind. I'll just fill up the bag and go around the neighborhood then.
よろしくお願いしますね.
I leave the store, clutching a bag stuffed with bread. I guess I'll start with this house here. After ringing the bell, I opened the door slightly and yelled inside. Heyo! Furukawa Bread's here for delivery!
Hi! Hi, hi, hi.
She comes up to me.
Hi, どうぞ.
Open the door wide and enter.
あら、お久しぶり. Okazaki-kun じゃない?
In front of me was the face of a regular customer I got well acquainted with during the time I worked at Furukawa Bread. Hello. So you lived here? I never knew.
こっちこそびっくりしましたよ。戻ってきてたんですか?
No, just for today and tomorrow. But the old man not being in the house right now and all.
あら、大変。どうしたの?
Two old friends of his are making a new troop, so he's going all the way to Kyushu to see them.
へえ。昔は仕事を休んで、そんなこと絶対できない人だったのに。 岡崎君がいてくれたからね。
Of course not. We actually had to go through a great deal just to persuade him to go.
でしょうね。
Although, I did end up having to work on my days off because of all of this.
若いから大丈夫。
I sure hope so. Well, here's the usual. And over the vinyl bag I've been carrying.
いつもありがとね。 アキオさんにはよくしてもらってばっかりで、先日直してもらったお風呂も壊れる前より調子良くなってすごく助かったのよ。Dang,
he fixed the bath. Bath?
ええ。ついこの間、お風呂が壊れてね。銭湯に行こうと用意してたら、アキオさんがパンを配りに来て、それで訳を話したら、見せてみろって上がり込んでき。
Wow.
あの人らしいでしょ?
Yeah, kinda.
ちょっと待っててね。その時のお礼もしたいから。
Leaving me, she disappears out into the hallway for a time. She then comes back carrying a large cardboard box.
これビールなんだけど、持って行ってもらえる?
Sure. I'm sure the old man will be happy. I'm back!
おかえりなさい!
おかえりなさいです! ちょうどできたところです!
The room is filled with the smell of curry.
Konbanwa, seafood tappuri no kare desu.
Curry is one of my favorite food. It's been a while since I stayed here at the Furukawa household. It's not like we couldn't have gone to Nagisa room instead, but since Anaya-san told us to, we'll lay our futons in the guest room. Please just use the guest room for today, alright? That wording, how should I put it? I look at Nagisa in her nightwear. It's kinda lewd, isn't it?
Shikemashitaka, Tomoya-kun?
Yeah, it's all done.
Chotto hashi orechatemasu.
Nagisa flats into now. Sorry.
いいです. こういうのは 私の役目です.
What do you mean?
その… トモヤ君のお世話をすることです.
It must be rough, seeing as I'm such a slob.
そんなことないです. どちらかというと… 嬉しいです.
That's so.
はい!
For some reason, all I can think about is the old man. Just keep tossing and turning, not able to fall asleep. Next, the face is right in front of me.
Tomoya-kun, 眠れないですか?
Nah, I'll probably get to sleep soon enough.
何考えてますか?
Should I tell her? I'ma tell her. I'm so curious. Something dirty.
エッチなことですか?
I just want to see what happened.
どうしましょう? その… 今実家ですし…
Just kidding.
Huh?
I was just wondering how you respond if I said that.
Tomoya-kun. ひどいです. 私… 真剣にどうしたらいいか考えてしまいました.
Yeah, and that's exactly the reaction I wanted to see.
Tomoya-kun, 絶対変な趣味してます. Tomoya-kunは… エッチなことするより… 私をいじめて反応を楽しむ方がいいんですね.
Don't put it that way!
わかりました. 覚えておきます.
God damn it. She's making it sound like he's a loser now. She sulks, facing the wall. I'm telling you, it was just a joke! Get out my futon and brace her from behind. Whenever I say something you dislike, that's a joke. But no, actually, I'm always serious. It just makes me incredibly happy whenever I'm close to you. So, is it alright if we stay like this?
で、しびれないですか?
My right arm is underneath her hip, thus being sandwiched by it. It'll go numb, don't do it. Just until it goes numb then.
はい.
I press the tip of her nose, my nose, under the collar of her shirt. If you want me to be perfectly honest, it was the old man I was thinking about.
お父さんのことですか?
Yeah. I always felt like he just went around doing whatever he wanted. But I finally kind of realized he doesn't do that just for himself.
誰のためでしたか?
No, well, probably not for anyone in particular. And he himself is probably still just doing whatever it is he wants to do. But despite all that, a lot of people need him. I wonder if I've been acting similarly. Could I have been helping out those kids that were aiming to become regulars in their baseball team? Help them out with their fielding practice? I might, if the kids actually enjoyed it. In that case, I wonder if I could even find myself wanting to go fix people's bath heaters without them even asking me. Could I do that just to kill off some time? No, not me at least. I felt this too, whenever I stood next to him. Watching him as he made other smiles, yeah, it kinda gets on my nerves. Still, It makes me wonder just how anxious an Aisan must feel all the time. Since at any time, that guy can just go off somewhere to make someone smile. That's the kind of husband she burdened with.
Akio-san, dame desu yo. Itsu datte Akio-san wa sugu inakunatte shimau desu kara.
I recall Sanae-san's somewhat troubled expression from back then. I feel a bit bad for her. She asked, probably because I went silent. Yeah, we have to get up early tomorrow too, so I guess I'll sleep.
はい、わかりました.
I softly slipped my arm out from underneath her and returned to my own bed.
おやすみなさいです.
Yeah, good night.
Tomoya-kun. 朝です。そろそろ起きてパンを焼きましょう。
When I open my eyes, Nagisa face is right in front of my nose.
起きました。おはようございます。
Screw it! We've been a cherry boy the entire first round. It's time to make Okazaki less of a bitch. Let's go. I finally embrace her neck, and she tries to get back up.
What?
I finally embrace her. Nagisa!
Hi.
I grind my nose into the back of her neck.
Tomoya-kun, nebokete-masu.
I'm not half asleep. I just want to embrace the person I love, as is normal. Grind, grind. Oh, what? You don't like it?
そんなこと聞かないでほしいです.
Knock, knock. Huh? What was that? Rattle.
お二人さん, おはようございます.
Whoosh! I immediately let go of Nagisa's arm. Nagisa also jumps up and sees herself back in my bedside.
おはようございます, お母さん.
Morning!
お邪魔だったみたいですね.
No! Not at all!
Tomoya-kun, nebokete-tan-desu.
Mou-skoshi yukkuri-shite-moratte-ite-ii-desu-kara. Shitaku-ga-dekitara, omise-no-hou, onegai-shimasu-ne.
No, no! We'll just go right away!
Hai, sou-desu.
Sanae-san closed the door and smiled. A smile her only response.
Okaa-san-ni-mirarete-shimai-mashita.
Yeah, she totally saw us.
とても恥ずかしかったです.
Yeah, I actually forgot that we were in your parents' house just now.
やっぱりともやくん寝ぼけてました.
Half asleep? It's more like I just forgot.
一緒だと思います.
No, it isn't. Now come on, let's get dressed so we can go.
はい.
All right, let's do this. I keep on baking bread in front of the oven, sweating.
Ah,今日は渚もいてくれますし、智也さんはゆっくり休んでいてください.
Nah, I'll just keep on helping Nagisa too.
いえ、私がいれば人手は足りますので.
Does it really matter if we have too many people? Wouldn't it be more fun if we all work together?
はい、そうですね.
After that, I head over to the store to help out with the selling bread. Manning just a single register with three people was inefficient, no matter how you look at it. Nobody touched the subject though, as we continue helping the customers with a smile.
そろそろお昼ご飯の支度をしてこようと思いますので、しばらくお任せしますね.
あ、手伝います。いえ、もう客足もそうないですし、二人でお話でもして待っていてください。
She says and goes into the house. Well, let's do what she says. I grab her shoulder too, keeping her here.
あ、はい。では、どんなお話をしていましょう?
can't really come up with a topic when you ask me so directly like this. In that case, how about we talk about your first love? Yeah, I'd quite like to know. Okay. Man, you're late!
遅いですか?でも、本当です。そういうこと、奥手だったんです。
She does seem like a late bloomer, to be honest, though.
ですので、ともやくんから告白してもらえて、よかったです。でないと、ずっと何も言えなかったです。
That's so. It's nice your first love bore fruit, huh?
よかったです。
First loves don't usually come to fruition like this, you know.
ありがとうございます。
No, it's not just because of me. Besides, I'm also lucky you hadn't gone out with anyone else until the day we met. You look like you go out with just about anyone, because you feel bad for refusing someone.
そんなことないです。ともやくんだけです。他の人に告白されても、付き合ったりしてなかったです。他の人には告白されなかったですけど。
Damn, dog. Well, she's 19, 20, 20 years, no one confessed to her. That's so.
はい。
I don't believe it. I honestly don't believe it. I think somebody probably confessed to her, but she probably never realized she was being confessed to. I think that's probably what happened.I think things would have been different if her health... Oh, okay, that might be another reason, actually. Okay, I believe it now. I think things would have been different if her health didn't keep her from going to school regularly. I tried calling to mind what kind of guy would fall in love with Nagisa. I bet it'd just be someone just like Nagisa. A somewhat timid late bloomer that doesn't stand out too much. Someone that fall in love at first love, sight.But wouldn't really manage to start a conversation with her. And only on graduation day, knowing he won't be able to see her again starting tomorrow, he finally mustered up his courage and confessed. Looking at it from the outside, that would be quite a suitable couple. Ah, but that's the complete opposite from me, isn't it? My pairing is really hilarious if you're thinking it that way.
Tomoya-kun の初恋はどんな人でしたか?
Huh? Mine?
はい。ぜひ聞きたいです。
I wanna know too. Nah, it's pretty normal, really. I think it was the teacher back in my first year in elementary school. I actually always been attracted more to older women rather than to my classmates.
そうですか。希望に添えて何よりです。
え?
いえ、なんでもないです。
I think he forgot that she's older than him. We eat some nice and homemade lunch. Today was rice casserole with shrimp, and tend to store again with the three of us. Almost as if the hustle and bustle this morning had been nothing but a lie, and store in the afternoon was deserted.
今日も来ますでしょうか?
Don't know. I'm wondering the same thing.
何がですか?
Some brah.
子供ですか?
Yeah, I went and watched him practicing yesterday.
お父さんみたいです。
No, no. I'm certain it was the completely opposite.
そうでしょうか。そっくりだったと思います。
Even though we seem the same, we're different on the inside. We continue our added chatter. I'm the first to turn around when I sense that someone come to me. The kid from yesterday peeks through the entrance with just his face.He really came. To be honest, I'm a bit happy.
Tomoya-san, 頑張ってきてくださいね。
Sanae-san says, supporting me.
Konnichiwa.
The kid said nothing, even to Nagisa greeting. He doesn't even make eye contact with me. I probably did something to make him hesitant toward me. Because I really am just bad at dealing with people. This is truer still than dealing with children.They really are different on the inside. Even if we're similar, I realize this now. The child might have just wanted to see if the old man has come back yet. And if the old man isn't here, he might just head back again immediately. I wonder if there's anything I can do here right now. What would I do at a time like this if I were the old man? Ah, I see. The guy doesn't think one bit about how he should act, does he? So the answer is simple. Alright, we're going to have a match today. I say, facing the child. How about a home run contest? The loser has to treat the winner to juice. Don't worry, it's been a while since I held a bat. Alright, Nagisa, I'm off.
Hey.
Just so you know, I magically hit the old man fastball into a home run. Naturally. Yeah, that's right. So you better throw everything you have at me. The new battle pass? No, I haven't seen it. I've just been grinding Grand Blue Fantasy all day today. Clink! He's evil. Are you gonna buy it? Yeah, I might. I don't know, $20 a month is a lot. I'm not gonna lie. That's a lot. I gotta see what it looks like. Here it is. Apron? Nah, I'll pass. I'm not a big maid apron kind of guy. I'll pass. That's $20, so nah. Clink! That's a little bit disappointing. It's December. I was expecting Santa outfit or something. Gah! My ball got hit by an elementary school student! As expected, I couldn't really throw the ball very well. Bro, I didn't say sexy. All I said was Santa outfit, man. Come on, bro. It's December. Who think about maids in December? French maids. You think about Santa and miniskirts. Huh? When I turn around, I see a bunch of children gathering in front of me, looking at me. Whoa, this is incredible. Something small like this has changed things that much? I was only trying to have a good time along with him. Fine then, we can play too. Would that be okay? I feel like I got to experience a world I've never seen before. I'm back! When I get back home, Sanai-san is manning the register by herself and Naika is nowhere to be seen. How did she know? I'm not sure whether that's supposed to be a praise or not.
もちろん褒めたつもりですよ。私はアキオさんのそういうところ大好きですから。
Is that so? Still can't feel genuinely happy whenever someone says that. Though right now, I don't feel bad about it either. So, where's Nagisa?
今でテレビを見ていると思いますよ。
Nah. What is this girl doing? I know she's bored, but come on!
いえ、暇だからというわけではなくて
Oh, shit!
何か大きな事件が起きたみたいなので、見ているんですよ
An incident? So she's watching the news?
渚に聞いてみてください
Guess so. Well, I'll be off for a bit then. When I entered the living room, Nagisa sat down on the floor, right in front of the CRT TV, her face illuminated by the lights. What's wrong? Why are you sitting here in the dark? How engrossed can you get? I turned the lights and walked up to her. Nagisa! I poke her cheek with my finger.
Hi.
Finally, having noticed I'm here, she looks my way. What's wrong? Why are you so engrossed in this? We both transfer our gaze onto the TV. It is on the image of a bus running rampant, being followed up high by a helicopter. It was something you often see on those TV programs where they make montages of car chases from overseas.
バスがハイジャックされたそうです。Huh?
Sounds bad.
高速バスです。九州です。Oh! 何か胸騒ぎがしませんか?
No, not really.
よく考えてみてください。Wait,
don't tell me.
はい。 お父さんが乗ってるかもしれないです。
That'd be too much of a coincidence.
そんなこと言い切れないです。
Well, yeah. I can't be sure, but... So, Sanae-san doesn't know yet?
はい。 詳しい話はまだしてないです。
That's so. So you've been watching this entire time in place of Sanae-san? So she wouldn't get worried.
Hi.
I placed my hand on Nagisa's head and stroke her hair gently. I hear the announcer voice coming from the TV in a low volume, reporting on the situation. The bus had gone into a service area and stopped. I could see several nurse and doctor robes running up there from the edge of the screen. The front door of the bus opens. My eyes open wide. Elderly people descend out from inside the bus. Many passengers were getting off the bus there. All of them women, children, and the elderly. The door of the bus then closes and drives off again. I can hear a sigh of relief coming from Nagisa. Before I realize it, I'm holding Nagisa's shoulder. In my mind, I thought it would just be too big of a coincidence. But I wonder why. Maybe Nagisa's words had transferred over to me. For some reason, I couldn't help but feel he was there. Suddenly, the phone rings, and Nagisa and I exchange glances.
私、出ます。Nagisa
gets up and picks up the phone in the living room.
はい、古川です。はい、変わります。Nagisa
puts her hand over the receiver and hangs her head.
お母さんにです。Okay.
I'll go get her then. I guess it'd be better if we leave the TV off, huh?
はい、お願いします。
I get up and, after turning off the TV, leave the room to call Sanae-san. Sanae-san! Phone!
はい、ありがとうございます。すぐ行きますね。
Nagisa holds onto my shirt the entire time Sanae-san is on the phone. Who's on the other end? I see now.
ありがとうございました。
She puts down the receiver.
Nagisa.
Sanae-san calls Nagisa's name.
テレビつけてくれますか?
何か見ますか?
ニュースです。お願いできますか?
はい。
Nagisa picks up the remote control and pushes the switch. Before the image is even visible, you can hear the announcer tensely continue to report on the pursuit.
どのチャンネルですか?
そこでいいですよ。
Sanae-san fixedly watches the image that emerges on the screen. Nagisa and I do the same, holding our breath.
Nagisa.
Is the old man really on there? Ask her and place the Nagisa.
Akio-san を見送ってくれた方からだったんですけど、そのバスかもしれないと言っていました。
I see. Actually, Nagisa was over anxious about things, so she's been watching this alone, so you wouldn't get worried.
そうだったんですか? Nagisa, ありがとうございますね。
いえ。
Tomoya-san も。
I haven't done anything. Together, we continue looking at the image transmitted from the helicopter. New information keeps coming in one after another. And the people that were dropped off from the bus. How the criminal had been single, had been a single young man. How he threatened the driver with a knife to make him move the bus. And how one man was stabbed with that knife and had suffered an injury. Apparently he got stabbed because he kept persistently trying to persuade him to give it all up. It's Akio-san. Everyone in the room is thinking the same thing. There's no way that guy would just stay still in that situation. His sense of justice backfired. Apparently the criminal also refused to let the nurses at the bus treat him. But how bad of a wound is it? If they just slash him to intimidate him, it's probably fine. But if he was stabbed seriously and continue losing blood without being able to stop it, then it would be just a matter of time before... only bad things are coming to mind. It must be the same for Sanae-san. She watches the TV intently, her hands clenched together as if in prayer. Once again, the bus stopped at the service area to let all passengers. The image is so small that I can't really see what's happening. There are quite a few people being let off. There are young men mixed in this time. The familiar face of the old man, holding a cigarette in his mouth, always looking as if he was about to complain about something. Isn't there? The door closes. Once again, the bus drives on. After that, the same thing continues. If he got him off the bus just now, we should have gotten a phone call right away telling us that he's safe. However, one didn't come. Then again, we got new information from the people that were dropped off. The only person left inside the bus right now are the bus driver, the criminal, and the man who suffered an injury. And when the man was stabbed during his attempt to persuade the criminal, it was in that battering. He didn't even dodge it. After he was stabbed, he just continued trying to persuade the criminal with a smile as the sweat poured from his forehead. Damn. Just something I could see the old man doing. Due to the man's persuasions, he managed to get all the passengers let off the bus. In exchange, he ended up remaining on it, along with the bus driver. Even while suffering from a grave injury. We continue listening to the coverage of the situation with our eyes closed. Then, the next service area. The bus remained at the stop. The person who appeared from the open door is a man of familiar stature. It's a figure of the man holding a cigarette in his mouth, always looking as if he's about to complain about something. However, he's slouching more than normal. He leaned his weight on the body on the bus, looking as if he's in pain. I can't quite see his wound because he's wearing a black top, but his jeans is stained with blood, like someone spilled black paint all over them. He faced the police while keeping distance from them, but the bus driver is still being held hostage inside the bus. He has some kind of exchange with them, but it's too far away, so I can't quite tell what is happening. I wonder if they're not allowed to show his face on TV in this sort of situation. Police carry a megaphone, or at least I think it is, to the bus and throw it toward it. The injured man picked it up slowly. He checks to see whether it's turned on, and then starts shouting something. It isn't quite audible. The man looks satisfied. He gets on the bus once again. Descending from the bus and instead is the bus driver wearing his uniform. The moment the bus driver gets down to the ground, the door closes and the bus departs. The tires slip as the bus makes a large U-turn and leaves the service area behind. Police cars and ambulances immediately follow after it. The only ones left inside are the young man and the injured man. So he's the one driving the bus right now. Just what's that guy trying to do? We all hold our breath, carefully watch over the proceedings. After a few moments, a videotape recording is played back. With the audio corrected, you could now hear what he had been saying. We're going to be setting out on a trip now. I can hear him. We actually click with each other. We become friends. The boy has someone he wants to see. His grandmother who raised him when he was little. He said she'd been bedridden ever since 5 years ago. He doesn't know how she's doing right now. But despite that, he's going to come see her. When he checks to find out how she's doing, I'm going to make sure I'm next to him so he can get through it. Alright, you understand? Damn. I wonder if that young man is smiling right now. Having found such a reassuring friend. He probably is. That guy can get along with anyone, no matter who they are. He will then make them smile. I knew it. You really are amazing. I couldn't catch up to him, even if I worked at it my entire life. The bus winds its way through the highway at an earth-shattering speed. He's bleeding so much. His consciousness must be fading by now. He's traveling with death. He's probably enjoying himself immensely right now. Every time it looks like he's about to plunge into a medium strip. Every time the bus swings over so much it looks like he's about to tip over. He's probably laughing out loud. The image goes blurry. Before I know it, tears have formed in my eyes. What's this? I wipe them off, then look at Nagisen and Aisan. They're both the same. They're smiling, their eyes filled with tears. I wonder what it is, this feeling we're all having right now. I don't quite understand it. The bus continues running wild on the TV screen. It slowly eases up its velocity. And then, failing to make the next turn, it crashes into the medium strip. Now stranded, the bus finally crawls to a stop. It's surrounded by police cars and ambulances. One after another, the police breaks the window on the bus, climbing inside. It announces reports the conclusion of the incident. We're in the hospital, in the neighboring town. The hallway, illuminated by fluorescent lamps, is filled with a heavy atmosphere. The doctor had told Sanai-san he'd done everything he could do, and that the rest would be up to his own life force. The old man, he saved many people's lives, and probably also that young man's mind. Still, I look at Sanai-san's profile, and she continues to wait with a smile, praying. He was someone who always go off somewhere. Someone who always did reckless things. I can't help but feel sorry for her, since she can't do anything but continue on waiting. That's something I always thought to myself. The old man is a wonderful human being, but I wonder if he's also a wonderful husband. Just what is Sanai-san to him? Is she the same as all those other people? I can't help but feel that way. Is there even a single thing that he can vow for Sanai-san and not someone else? Look away from her. Please, God, don't let this woman feel sad anymore. I pray. The old man kept on sleeping throughout the day. And then, on a morning 2 days later, when I come back from getting a change of clothes, I bump into Nagisa, running across the hallway in a fluster. What's wrong?
Tomoya-kun.
She says after catching her breath.
お父さんがいなくなってしまいました.
Wait, what does that mean? Are you saying he's woken up?
はい、多分起きてそのままフラッと.
Dang. I cover my face with my hand. Damn, that guy.
まだ傷口だって塞がってないはずです. 遠くに行かなければいいんですが.
Yeah, I'll go and look outside. He split up and started looking for the old man. Sanai-san probably also looking somewhere else. This has to be unprecedented. Having a seriously wounded patient go missing like that just after they gained consciousness? He shouldn't even be able to move about all that much due to the pain from his wound. So reckless. If he's really alright, then why doesn't he just show us his smiling face? He really doesn't know. Just how much we all been longing for it. There, he is. Sitting on a bench, looking down toward the ground. What are you doing here, old man? Damn, I'm not gonna lie. I thought he's dead. I thought he'll die. In my head, I created a theory. I was like, damn, are they gonna kill him? Maybe Maybe he's gonna go to the world where his daughter's at, right? Because we find out about that world. The illusion world is actually made from the world from his daughter. Maybe Akio will go talk to her or something. But they have him alive, so I wonder what they're gonna do with it next. He looks up at me with a pained expression. Were you trying to play hide and seek with something? You realize we were worried and looking all over for you. You're supposed to be wounded, seriously. You're so damn reckless.
So, then.
Come on, let's get back. How can you be so easygoing? The old man takes out a pack of cigarettes. He sticks one of them in his mouth. For a moment, I didn't understand what he was talking about. The police. I do remember them coming to see Sanae-san yesterday. So, he grabbed one of those policemen here just now and asked them what happened? In that case, he must be talking about that boy. I think his grandmother was the person he was supposed to be heading off to go see. But she's gone now. That's so.
でもまあ本人は取り乱さずにいたそうだ。すでに覚悟はしてたんだろうな。
No, it's obvious because of you.
そうか。だってあいつがブレーキ踏みやがったんだぜ。
Huh?
俺が意識なくす寸前、もういいって言ってさ。
Damn. No, I'm telling you, it's also all because of you. But I decided to stop telling him that.
で、 警察のやつも面会に来てやってくれって言ったからさ 今から行こうとしたんだが
What?
やっぱ無理だ 傷口がまた開いてきたかも
He's holding his hand on the stomach region of his pajama where blood is starting to spread
He's fine
Yeah, I don't know I didn't remember if the OSC played first or not. Old man. But the OSC, when this OSC played, I knew to be glad though, that's for sure. There's no way anything bad could happen when this OSC is playing. He lights a cigarette in his mouth with his lighter. He really, really is an amazing person. There's nobody in the world who could hope to tie this person down.
また見つかっちまった.
The old man looks behind me.
Akio-san!
When I turn around, Sanae-san standing there.
Yo, Sanae.
Tears well up in her eyes when she sees the old man's body. She must have been worried from the bottom of her heart.
Akio-san.
He stubs out his cigarette on a nearby public ashtray, and then he slowly gets up, straight up without yielding to the pain. He looks at Sanae-san.
I'm not going to be here. だから安心しろ、サナエ。
Damn, he's pretty cool.
はい。お願いしますね。
No way! That's the end? I didn't get a light! What the hell? It can't end. I didn't get a light! Oishota and Minase and Nori sing together. Dang, really? That's cool. I didn't know they sing together. Oishota is amazing. He's amazingly talented. Isn't that the guy that can do any voice? High-pinched voice all the way to the ceiling? And he can do a girl voice. That's talent. I'ma wait. There has to be more. It can't be it. That can't be it. I have to get a light. So I guess the point of this route is for Okazaki Tomoya, right, that's name, Tomoya to step into Akio's shoes, to realize that Akio is actually godlike. I mean, come on, bro, you should have been knowing he's godlike, though. I guess he really did feel like that, huh? Alright. There's definitely something after. Alright, good. I'm like, no way. Akio was the MC of Clannad, the prequel to Clannad. I don't understand what that means. MC for the prequel. I wonder who's like the coolest character in each key studio that I know of. I never read Kanon. Like I said, the only one I know is Little Busters. Now Clannad. Technically Harmonia and Planetarium, but I don't want to count them, to be honest, because they're too short and rewrite. I think for Little Buster, that's the easy choice. Kiyosuke, he's super cool. And then for rewrite, I want to say Sakia, maybe. Sakia or the old man? The old man was mad cool too. Oh, his character's like an MC, so it's chill. Then he can be a badass. Didn't they say Akio's like Tomoya? They keep saying that. He does remind me of Tomoya, but like an older version of him. Because Tomoya kind of like talk like Akio. I got his light, but he didn't even do anything. Tomoya don't deserve that light. Come on, bruh. I guess he realized he didn't even help Akio at all. Oh shit. You didn't see it. I got a trophy. And the music change. You think I should do the ending right now? Or should I save it for next week? You think true ending would be long? You see the lights? On the grass? Oh, you do see the light! Right there. Oh! You can't see it. You can see it. Ending now, please.